The crochet pug dog measures 12 by 14 inches. The 12 inches is the height and the 14 inches is the length. This is just a close-up of the crochet dogs. This one I named Pixie, and this one's Prince. The only difference is the style of yarn that I used. With Prince, I used the Karen 1 pound, and it's the cream color with the black. And then he has a real pet outfit on. So it's a medium-sized pet outfit. It's a Chewbacca Star Wars pet collection. And it has a reflective vest on it. It'll fit a real dog. He has his collar on, which comes off also. It's a real dog collar, and he has his name tag on. Pixie also has all items that can be used on a real dog. So these are little clips that go on the dog, and they fit right through the crochet holes. Look like a decoration for her. And then she also has a real collar, elastic collar on, and also a real dog outfit, which is adorable. You could attach the leash. If you have a real dog, this would make a neat gift for someone, and they can take this off and use it on a real dog. And this is where they would attach their leash. It's a medium-sized dog outfit. For this project, you're going to need your F or 4 millimeter crochet hook. You're also going to need a pair of scissors and a tapestry needle. I used Suncatcher Craft Dyes 18 millimeter. For Pixie, I'm using the aqua colored eyes. And then for Prince, I used just regular black, the solid black 18 millimeter eyes. For both of them, I use the Doris animal noses, and they're the 18 millimeter sized nose. For the yarn, I used Red Heart Super Saver. One of the colors was Orchid, and here's more information about this yarn. I also used Red Heart color Amethyst, a little bit of a darker purple, and I just used a white colored yarn. You could use a Red Heart quality yarn that's white, or I use this Craftsman Value yarn, just a regular white colored yarn, and here's some information on this yarn. For Prince, I used the Karen 1 pound yarn, and the color was cream. Then I also used just a Red Heart black colored yarn. The first thing we're going to start with is the front panel of the head, and I'm using a lighter color, the Orchid color. So the first thing you're going to do is we're going to make the slip knot. So you're just going to take and fold the yarn over on itself to form a loop. Then take your crochet hook, and I'm using my F or 4 millimeter crochet hook. Go right through the loop. Hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and your thumb. Then just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Go ahead and pull on that loose yarn end to make the knot nice and snug. Then you could pull on the yarn to cause it to go around your crochet hook. And then we're going to make a chain. I'm going to show you a few of the chains, but you're going to end up making 26. So I'm just going to show you four of them. You just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the loop for one, two, three, four. You can see how I'm making a chain. Go ahead and finish a chain of 26 and then come back. This is what your chain should look like when you're done. And again, I have a chain of 26. Then you're going to take your crochet hook and you're going to go into the second chain from the hook. So this is the first chain and here is the second chain. So you just take your crochet hook and you're going to go into the second chain from the hook. You're going to bring up a loop. You have two loops on your hook. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. Then you're going to go into the next stitch over. You bring up a loop. Two loops on the hook. Yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through both for a single crochet. And you're going to make a single crochet in every stitch back across. I'm going to make one more with you. And then I'll let you finish up. When you reach the end, come back and I'll show you what to do next. So this is how my work looks so far. You can see that I've reached the end and I made my single crochet into my last stitch. When you've made the last single crochet, then you're going to make a chain of one. Just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, go back through the loop for a chain one, then go ahead and turn your work. Then you're not going to work into the base of that first chain one, so you're not going to be working in that stitch. You're going to go into the next stitch over. So you're going to go into that next stitch over, bring up a loop, and you're just going to make a single crochet all the way back across. And that's what you're going to do until you've completed 22 rows. So that first chain was your first row. We finished the second row. Then we made a chain one, turned your work, and we're working on the third row right now. So go ahead, finish completing 22 rows for your front panel of the dog's head, and then come back. I finished the 22 stitches. You can see how I have a straight edge on all sides, which is what you want. After you finish your 22nd row, then you can go ahead and finish off. Just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the loop and bring just a little bit of the yarn through to bury your loose yarn end. And then just pull that loose yarn in snug. And that is the front panel. So we finished the front panel. The back panel is made the exact same way. You start with a chain of 26. The only difference is the back panel, you only need 19 rows. So the front panel had 22 rows, and the back panel only has 19 rows. And the reason why the back panel has less is because we put some wrinkles in when we're making the face with the front panel. When you're finished with the front and the back panel, the side panel is made the exact same way. The only difference is you start with a chain of 60 and you only need 8 rows for the side panel. So for the side panel, you start with a chain of 60 and only 8 rows. For the snout, we're going to use the darker color, whatever color that you're using for your snout. For mine, I'm using the darker purple, also called amethyst. So to start with the magic circle, you're just going to take the yarn, drape it across your four fingers, use your thumb to stabilize, Wrap it around your two middle fingers twice. And then hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. Then you're going to take your crochet hook, you're going to go under those two loops that you had around your middle fingers. You're going to bring up a loop. And then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for your slip knot. Now you're going to make six single crochet into the magic circle. So you take your crochet hook, go under those two loops, bring up a loop, two loops on your hook, yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through the two loops for one single crochet. Two. Three, four, five, and six. Then you're going to take your forefinger and your thumb, and you're going to hold the base. So you have your crochet hook in your hand, and then hold the base with your forefinger and thumb. Then you have these two loops on the opposite side. You're going to pull on one of them. If it doesn't close, let go and pull on the other one, but this one's closing, so just gently close it. We can close it more later. Then take the loose yarn in and pull on that. Then just take and turn your work. And then in that first stitch, you're going to make two single crochets. So take your crochet hook, go into the first stitch of the magic circle. You're going to bring up a loop. Make a single crochet. So that's one. Go into the same stitch and make another one. And then you're going to make two single crochet into every stitch around until you have a total of 12. And then come back. Now you can take and turn your work over. If you need to close the center of the magic circle, just turn your work over, take that loose yarn end and pull on that snugly, and that will close up the center of your magic circle. Then you're going to take a loose scrap of yarn, or take a yarn marker to place it right where you left off. And we're going to continue the increase rounds. And by increase rounds, I mean that we're increasing the number of stitches around our circle. Right now we have 12. So for those that know how to increase, we're going to be increasing we're going to stop at one single crochet in six stitches and two single crochet in the seventh stitch. For the beginners, I'm going to show you the first couple increase rounds. So in the first stitch, you're going to make one single crochet. And then in the second stitch, you're going to make two single crochet in the same stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. I'm going to do one more with you. One single crochet in the first stitch. And then two single crochet in the second stitch. And then you just keep repeating that pattern all the way around until you get to the yarn marker. And then come back. So now I'm back to the yarn marker and I completed 18 stitches around the circle. When you reach the yarn marker, go ahead and take it out and move it up to where you left off. And we're going to get ready for the next increase round. Now for the next increase round, you're going to make one single crochet into the next two stitches. And then two single crochet into the third stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the yarn marker. And then come back. So you should have finished 24 stitches around the circle for that last round. This is the last round I'll do with you, and then I'll let you finish up the increase rounds. So for the next increase round, you're going to make one single crochet into 3 stitches. And then 2 single crochet into the 4th stitch. And then you're going to repeat that pattern, 1 single crochet into 3 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the 4th stitch, repeating that pattern all the way around to the yarn marker. And then for the next round, it'd be 1 single crochet into 4, and then 2 single crochet into the 5th, and then 5, and then 6. And the last increase round will be 1 single crochet into 6 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the 7th stitch, and then come back. I just finished my last round of 1 single crochet into 6 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the 7th stitch. And I have a total of 48 stitches around. After you finish that last increase round, you're just going to take your yarn marker and move it up. Then you're just going to make 1 single crochet in every stitch around until you've completed 3 rounds. So 3 rounds of only 1 single crochet in every stitch. So that means that every time you get to the yarn marker, you're always going to have 48 stitches. You shouldn't have more and you shouldn't have less. So go ahead, finish completing 1 single crochet in every stitch until you have 3 rounds, and then come back. Now you can see how I finished 3 rounds, 1, 2, 3 of 1 single crochet in every stitch. Now you're going to make a slip stitch into the next stitch over. So you just take your crochet hook, go into that next stitch, then you're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and then bring the yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. Then you can go ahead and finish off, just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, go through the loop, and then you want to bring enough yarn through to sew the snout onto the front panel of the head. Now you're going to need your front panel. Make sure that you don't grab the back panel. Remember, the back panel is a little bit shorter, so you want to grab the front panel. We're going to start putting the face together. Now you want to take the long end that you left for sewing, place it onto a tapestry needle, and place that bottom edge where you have the long end of your yarn along the bottom of the front panel. And then line it up to where you have 2 stitches on this side as well as 2 stitches on this side. So you want to center it. And then you're just going to take your tapestry needle and you're going to sew along the bottom edge. So you're going to go up just a little bit, about 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches up, just along the edge of the bottom of the snout only, just going in and out, sewing it to the front panel. Then you're going to go back . Continue sewing along the bottom edge until you get to the equal side on the opposite side. So I'm just going to do it with you. So you just keep sewing the bottom edge. Then you can take, turn the work over, and just tie a knot. That way it won't come undone. I like to go at least a couple times. And then we're going to place the nose. Then you want to take, here's the center of the magic circle, go up and place your nose right onto the end of the snout, and then go through the front panel, and you should have about 8 rows above the nose. So 8 rows on that front panel, and then center the nose, and this is how it looks so far. You can see how my nose looks. And then you can just take and place the safety latch on the other side once you have it centered the way you want it. Then just take and place that safety latch onto the back. Then you're going to push in the bottom part of the snout so that it overlaps. You're forming the upper snout. You should only have 1, 2, 3, 4 rows showing when you do that. And then you're going to take, get the same colored yarn with your tapestry needle so we could sew this down. So I have my tapestry needle with the same colored yarn. You want to hold the snout so that you have 1, 2, 3, 4 rows beneath the nose, and it's forming an upside down V. Then you can take, just going to fold a little bit more, your tapestry needle, and you're going to come in not through the back of the panel, just the back of the snout, with your tapestry needle. And you're just going to sew it in place. Just want to make sure that edge, that lip there. Then I'm going to go right back through and tie a knot. And then I'm just going to take and sew, just going right through the back of the snout only, coming through the front of the snout where I folded over the upper portion of the snout. I'm just going to go in and out. You can see how I'm going through the back of the snout and not the front panel. And then I'm just going to take and sew through the back of the snout, just sewing the fold in place. Go ahead, finish sewing all the way across, and then come back. Then once I've finished sewing all the way across, I'm going to go ahead and just tie a knot. Just to hold it in place. One time will be okay for that part of it. Then you can go ahead and get your craft stuffing. I just use a pillow that I get from Walmart, an inexpensive pillow, and then just use the stuffing inside of the pillow. Then you just take your craft stuffing and just put it right behind the snout. Then the snout is ready to be sewed down. You're going to form a little triangle with the upper part of the snout. Then once you know the position for the upper part of the snout, you remember you're forming that triangle with the snout, you want to make sure you have the same number of stitches on this side as you do on the other side. So I have here about 6 stitches, and I'm going to take my tapestry needle, holding the snout in place where I want to sew it. Now you can take your tapestry needle and go through the back panel. Finish sewing this side of the snout down. And then just starting to sew all the way up towards the nose. Just going in and out, sewing the upper part of the snout in place. And then come back. So I sewed half of it down. Now I'm going to work on the other side. Make sure you form it and that it's equal on the same this side as it is on the other side, and then finish sewing it in place. Now the snout is sewed in place, and you could tie a knot on the back. Just cut your loose yarn ends short so they don't get in your way. Now we're going to start on the eyes. You're going to take your white yarn, and just like we did before, we're going to start with a magic circle. Just take the yarn, drape it across your 4 fingers, use your thumb to stabilize. Wrap the yarn around your 2 middle fingers and hold it in place with your pinky and your thumb. And then we're going to bring up a loop, yarn over, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to make 6 single crochet into the magic circle, just like we did before for the snout. That's 3. And 6. And I'm just going to hold the base of the 6 single crochet. I'm going to close up the magic circle. Don't close it too tight because you want to fit the eye, the back part of the eye, into the center of the circle. So just close it up just a little bit. You can close it more later around the eye, and then just take that loose yarn in and pull on that. You can see how I have an opening. Then you're going to take and go into that first stitch. We're going to make 2 single crochet into that first stitch. And we're going to make 2 single crochet in every stitch around until we have a total of 12. So that's 2. So 2 single crochet in every stitch around until you have a total of 12, and then come back. So I just finished my last stitch. I have a total of 12 stitches around my magic circle. I have a nice opening in the center. Now I'm going to make a slip stitch into the first stitch. So you go into that next stitch, yarn over, and then bring the yarn through both loops on the hook for a slip stitch. Then you can go ahead and finish off, just yarn over and pull enough yarn through to sew it onto the dog. Now you can get your eye, your safety eye. Now I have the eye that I'm using. You can either use the solid black 18 millimeter eye, or you can have fun and just have a different colored eye. I'm using the aqua colored one. And just going to take and place it in the center, and then on the back I'm going to go ahead and take the safety latch and place it first. Before I place it, just pull on that loose yarn end to snug the white part of the yarn around the backing of the eye. Then you can take
and place the safety latch. You're going to need two of these. After you finish both of your eyes, then we're going to make the backing that goes behind the eye. You're going to use your darker color, the same color as the snout, and you're just going to fold the yarn over on itself to form a loop, and then just hold the base of the loop, the middle finger and thumb, and just yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to make a chain of six. So just yarn over, go through the loop for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then you're going to turn, go the second chain from the hook, and make a single crochet all the way back. And that'll give you 5 stitches. Now we're going to make 2 more rows of just the 5 stitches. So the first thing you're going to do is chain 1, turn your work, go into the next stitch over, and make a single crochet all the way back in every stitch. You should have 5 stitches. We're going to make 1 more row of 5 stitches, so chain 1, turn your work, go into the next stitch, make a single crochet, and then a single crochet in every stitch back across. Now you're just going to turn your work. So you just turn your work. You're going to go into the next stitch over for 1 single crochet. Next stitch for 2 single crochet. Next stitch for 3 single crochet. And then next stitch for 4. The last stitch for 4 single crochet. And we're going to make 2 more rows of just 4 single crochet stitches. So the first thing you're going to do is chain 1, turn your work, go into the next stitch over for your second stitch, next stitch for your third, and then your last stitch for your fourth. Then you're going to chain 1, turn your work, go into the next stitch for 2 single crochet, next stitch for 3 single crochet, and then your last stitch for 4 single crochet. Then you're going to go ahead and finish off. Just yarn over and pull enough yarn through to sew it onto your work. And you're going to need 2 of these. After you finish 2 of these, then you're going to take the eye and make sure that when you center it on there that you leave some of the purple on the right side and some of the purple on the left, and then just center it right in the center of the backing. And then take your tapestry needle. I usually take the smaller part of the white portion of the eye first, and then bring that through to the back of the purple backing. And then you're going to sew the white part of the eye in place with the long end that you left for sewing. Just hold it in place as you sew. Whoops. Make sure I don't slip. Then you just take and sew the outer white portion of the eye to the purple backing. Just go all the way around with your tapestry needle and just sew it in place. Then you can just tie a knot on the back, and I usually leave the long white strands of yarn because I'm going to sew those into the back of the front panel. So now you can do the same thing to the other eye. Now you're ready to sew the eyes in place. So make sure that you have the smaller side of the purple end facing towards the nose on both sides, and then make sure that you only have a couple stitches on this side and a couple stitches on the other side, and then you just place the eye right up against the snout and sew it in place. So you could see how I placed the one eye, and then I brought the white yarn through to the other side, and now I'm sewing it in place with the darker purple yarn, and I'm just sewing all around the dark portion only. You don't want to sew the white of the eye, just the dark portion, and then just sew it all the way around. After you have the eyes in place, make sure that you have your eyes equal. You don't want one crooked. You may have to reposition it, but mine are where I want to have them. So now the next step is making the wrinkles for your dog. So the first thing you're going to do is just kind of fold a wrinkle above the eye, and it kind of will give your dog the sad look. You don't want it to have a mad look. So make sure that when you're folding your wrinkles that you have kind of a sad appearance. Then you're going to take your tapestry needle with the same colored yarn as the front panel, and you're going to come up from behind. Make sure you leave enough loose yarn end on the back for tying a knot. Then you're just going to go through the wrinkle, sewing it in place. So you're just going to place your wrinkles above the eye. Then go ahead and tie a knot on the back. You can use one of the loose yarn ends on the back to tie a knot. And that's all you do. You just hold the wrinkle in place, and then go in and out of the wrinkle to sew the wrinkle in place. And then when you come back, I'll show you what my wrinkles look like when I'm done. So far, I've just done the one eye, and you can see how I made a wrinkle here and a wrinkle there above the eye. Now I'm going to do the same thing, a wrinkle here and a wrinkle there above the other eye. And this is what the wrinkles look like on my eyes so far. I put one right here, and then around here, and then around here, and around there. And I think it looks great for mine. Now I'm going to show you how to put the roll that goes right over the nose. Now the strip that goes over the nose is made the same way as the side panel for the head, except you're going to start with a chain of 26, and there's only 4 rows. So a chain of 26, and then 4 rows of 1 single crochet in every stitch. Then you're going to take your tapestry needle on the long end that you left for sewing, or the same colored yarn, and you're going to take and fold the strip in half. And then once you fold it in half, you're just going to take your tapestry needle and you're going to take and sew the strip together. Sew it in half. So So just go in and out, sewing the strip in half, and then come back. Once you have the strip sewn together, leave the tapestry needle on the end that you left for sewing, or get some more yarn for sewing, and you're going to evenly place the strip so that it's above the nose and down along underneath the eye and down the sides of the snout. Make sure that it's equal on both sides and then sew it in place, making sure that you could still see the whites of the eyes on both sides. Now you could leave the eyes like this, or you can put eyelashes and you could put the strip that goes above the eye. So I'm going to show you how to make the eyelashes if you like the eyelashes. So you take whatever color you want for your eyelashes. I'm using the same color as the snout, and then put it onto my tapestry needle, and then I'm going to come through the side of where the white of the eye is. Make sure you leave enough yarn on the other side for tying a knot, and you're going to go straight over to the side. And then go ahead and tie a knot on the back. Then you're going to come back through, go straight up on the side, and then go back in the same area you came out of to form the top lash. Then you're going to come the same distance from the top. You're going to come in through the bottom lash, go in the same area you came out of, and that is the eyelash. And I'm going to put that on both sides. This is what mine looks like so far with the eyelashes. Now I'm going to show you how to make the strip above the eye. If you want to make that, you're going to use the yarn color, the same color that you used for your snout, and you're going to fold the yarn over on itself to form a loop. Put the crochet hook right through the loop. Hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and your thumb. You're going to yarn over, turn the hook upside down, and go through that loop for a slip knot. Then you're going to cinch the yarn around the loop around your crochet hook, and you're going to make a chain of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then you're going to take your crochet hook, go into the second chain from the hook, bring up a loop, make your single crochet, and you're going to make a single crochet in every stitch back across except for the last stitch. In the last stitch, we're going to make a slip stitch. So I have one stitch left. I'm going to make a slip stitch into that last stitch. I'm going to go into that last stitch. I'm going to yarn over, and then I'm going to bring the yarn through that stitch and through the loop on my hook for a slip stitch. Then you're going to finish off. You're just going to yarn over and pull enough yarn through to sew it onto the dog. And you're going to need 2 of these. Now you're going to position it over the eye, making sure that you don't give it a mad looking appearance, and also you don't want to cover your eyelashes. And then you just take and sew the flap over the eye. Just go in and out. And just sew the flap in place. This is what mine looks like. So you can see that it doesn't have a mad look to it. And then once you're happy with it, you go ahead and do the exact same thing on the other side. And this is what it looks like after I finished putting the eye flaps
on. Now we can sew the head together. You're going to take the side panel, the one side panel that you have, and we're going to line it up. The first thing you're going to do is just get your tapestry needle with the same colored yarn as the sides panel, and you're going to place the front of the face down where the right side is facing up. Then you're going to take your side panel for the head and you're going to lay it along the side right on top of the right side of the front panel. Then just make sure you line up the side with the edge, and then take your tapestry needle and you're just going to sew right along the edge of the side panel. And then you can go ahead and tie a knot with the loose yarn ends. Then you're just going to take your tapestry needle and you're just going to sew through that top stitch only, sewing the front panel to the side panel. You're going to sew it together, and then when you get to the top, come back because I'm going to show you how to put the wrinkles along the top of the head with the side panel. Also, when you come across the wrinkle on the side of the head, make sure you fold it so that you maintain the wrinkle. Hold it in place as you're sewing so you can sew the wrinkle in place. The wrinkles just add character to your dog, and it's kind of fun making your own wrinkles where you want them to give your dog a special character look. Now I just finished sewing along the one side of the panel, and now I'm across the top and I want to place a couple wrinkles. So I'm just going to fold over where I want the wrinkles, but you also don't want to use too much to where you don't have enough to finish going to the side. So what I do is I just take a little safety pin to kind of hold this in place. So here you can see where I placed a safety pin on the end. That way I know how much I'm going to need. I had a loose yarn end here where I tied the top of the head here, so I know how much I'm going to need for the last side, the other side. Now I know how much room I have to make as many wrinkles as I want across the top of the dog, and then I just sew them in place. So I finished sewing the side panel on. You can see how it fit perfectly, and this is what it looks like when I fold it over. You can see the wrinkles in place at the top of the head. Now we're going to sew the back panel in place. Now for the back panel, you're going to want to have the right side facing up. Then what I usually do is just place the back panel on top of the face. Then you can take, I have two loose yarn ends on the bottom edge corner. I'm going to go ahead and tie that in place. Then I'm going to take my safety pin and put it on the opposite corner. Then you're going to want to line up the edges to the top to make sure that they're straight. So I go ahead and I'm going to take my tapestry needle and tie a knot to the side panel. So here I can see that I have a straight edge from this side, so I just measure, make sure I have my straight edge. Then I just take and go through the top on that side and just tie a knot. That way it won't be crooked when you're done. You want to have a straight edge. So once you do that, then you can just take and remove the safety pin. You probably don't even need it, really. And then I'm going to start sewing from this edge so I can make sure it stays straight as I'm sewing. So I'm holding, I've already tied a knot on this side, so I know it's straight. And then I'm just going to hold this in place to keep it straight as I sew. And then I just take my tapestry needle. And of course I'm going to tie a knot to hold it in place. Then you just take your tapestry needle and sew the back panel in place the same way. Just go in and out along the edge and sew it in place. This is what my back panel looks like after I've sewed it in place. Then you can go ahead and turn the work so that the right side's facing out. You can see the wrinkles that I have on top of the head. And now I'm going to show you how to make the ears. Whatever color yarn that you used for the snout is the color yarn that you want for the ears. And you just take the yarn, fold it over on itself to form a loop, then just put your crochet hook right through the loop and hold the base of the loop with your middle finger and thumb. Just yarn over and pull the yarn through the loop for your slip knot. The first thing you're going to do is make a chain of 15. I'm just going to make 4 of them with you. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go ahead and finish your chain of 15 and then come back. So this is what my work looks like after making a chain of 15. Now you're going to take your crochet hook, go into the second chain from the hook, bring up a loop, you're going to make your single crochet, and then you're going to make a single crochet in every stitch back across, and then come back. This is what my work looks like so far. Now you're just going to make a chain of 1, turn your work, and then you're going to work into the next stitch over. And make 1 single crochet in every stitch across. You should have a total of 14 stitches. And you're going to make 8 rows the exact same way with 14 stitches in each, and then come back. This is what my work looks like after finishing 8 rows of 1 single crochet in every stitch. I just finished my last stitch. Now what you're going to do, you're not going to chain 1, you're just going to turn your work. So turn your work. And then you're going to go into the next stitch over and then make 1 single crochet in every stitch back across. So now you should have finished with only 13 stitches for that row, and you're going to do the same thing. You're not going to chain 1, you're just going to turn your work, go into the next stitch over, and make a single crochet in every stitch back across. Then you should have finished with 12 stitches, and you're going to keep doing that. Turn your work, go into the next stitch over, making 1 single crochet in every stitch until you get down to 4 stitches for the row, and then come back. So you could see how you start to form a triangle when you use that method. And now I have 4 stitches left. I'm going to turn my work, go into the next stitch, make a single crochet. So that's 1. Go into the next stitch for 2 single crochets. Third stitch for 3 single crochets. And then in the last 4th stitch, I'm going to make a slip stitch. So you take your crochet hook, go into that last stitch, yarn over, bring the yarn through both loops on your hook for a slip stitch, and then go ahead and finish off. Just yarn over and bring enough yarn through to bury into your work. And you're going to need 2 of these ears. After you finish both of your ears, then you're going to want to take your tapestry needle to bury that loose yarn in at the tip of the ear.
So you just take your tapestry needle and weave it in to the ear to bury it. And then just cut it. Then your ears are ready to sew on to the dog. So for my ears, I lined, this is the side panel, I went about a stitch back and lined up the top of the ear with the side of the eye, the furthest side of the eye. And then you want to make sure that the curl flaps forward so that it'll flap forward like this. And then I just placed the rest of the ear down, and you can see that I'm about, this is the back panel right here, about a row forward around the middle of the side panel, and I'm going to sew it in place. Then once you've sewn it in place, go ahead and let the ear flop forward. You want it to be the tip of the ear about the bottom of the eye, and then once you have it in position, go ahead and pinch it at the top, because you're going to take your tapestry needle and just sew that into the ear. You want the ear to flop forward like that. And then once you've put a couple stitches there, then you can take and go back into the center of the head and tie a knot. And then you want to sew the other ear on the exact same way. For the body, you're going to make it the same way that you made the snout. With the snout, you only increase to one single crochet into 6 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the 7th stitch. For the body, you're going to make it a little bit larger. So you're going to increase to 1 single crochet into 8 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the 9th stitch. After you finish all of your increase rounds, 1 single crochet into 8 stitches, and then 2 single crochet into the 9th stitch, you're going to take your yarn marker and move it up, and you're going to make 1 single crochet in every stitch until you've completed 40 rounds. So 40 rounds of 1 single crochet into every stitch around.